basically it's going to generate steam. You're going to go through a steam turbine, produce electricity. There will be some cooling, some non-contact cooling towers on site. And the cooling water for the cooling towers also coming from the wastewater treatment plant. The effluent that would be otherwise discharged into the creek will be used for the cooling water here. Control equipment here, we were talking selective catalytic reduction, a little bit different from SNCR here. I'll go into more detail about that in a few minutes. We've also got a sorbent injection system where there's lime or limestone blown into the exhaust gas to reduce sulfur emissions. And that limestone or lime dust is collected in a fabric filter, otherwise called a bag house. Okay, you got me there?
Documents
for some what the emissions from this facility are going to look like in a tons per year basis. Kind of the measuring stick when we were doing air quality permits is how much emissions are coming out on a ton per year basis. And so that's the threshold I want to present this in for you tonight. Particulate matter, it's PM. It's, you know, I'll use a lot of jargon and I'll try to, please forgive me, I'll try to put it in normal terms, but it's kind of nervous up here, so I might use a little bit of jargon. Particulate matter, that's soot from this facility. Potential emissions are right around 135 tons per year. The control technology that they will use to control the soot emissions would be a fabric filter baghouse. Fabric filter baghouse is very common and it has a very high level of emissions control efficiency. How they would be demonstrating compliance with this and one of their monitoring requirements, and in addition to initial stack testing, they would be required to do periodic monitoring or scheduled monitoring to make sure they're complying with their limits, to make sure their control devices are operating in an acceptable manner. In this particular case, they're going to have what we call a continuous opacity monitoring system. It's a little device, I won't say little, but it's a big device. It's continually measuring the opacity, which is the kind of the thickness, the darkness of the smoke that's coming out of there. SO2, sulfur dioxide. They have chosen a limit, take a limit of 247 tons per year. I mentioned before that the TSD threshold is 250 tons per year. How they're going to comply with that is the use of sorbent injection. I mentioned before the limestone injection, where the limestone gas and carbonate reacts with the SO2 molecules, basically precipitates out gypsum and reduces the sulfur dioxide emissions. They're going to comply with that regulation. I think right now we have it down as a continuous emissions monitoring system. That's what I have in this particular slide. And that's what's in draft permit as we speak for NOx. NOx is nitrogen oxides. Once again, 247 tons per year, just below that 250 tons. That's what's required by law. They're going to put on selective catalytic reduction, which is a catalyst using probably some sort of